Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of Crypto Miner Tips. And in today's tip, we're going to be talking about the 1066 gig. We're going to be covering the hash rate, the mining performance, and profitability. So it's going to be a full review about this card. And also, too, I'm going to be discussing some potential coins that you can mine. I do get asked quite a bit, quite a bit of questions about this card. I think that there's a lot of them out there on the market. A lot of gamers have them and stuff like that. And so, I get asked, what should I be mining with this 1060, or is it even a good card to mine? And so we're going to be discussing all that today and just kind of going over it. And as always, I'm going to have links down in the descriptions so you can check it out. I actually published an article recently about it. And, the thing about the 1060 card is it wasn't a popular choice when it first released in 2016. That was around the time that the RX 470s and the 480s from AMD, and also to the RX 580s. But as those cards became sold out in the 2017, the 2060 did become a pretty popular option. So there's a lot of miners out there that built rigs with them. And so, there's still quite a few of them on the market. And so I just kind of wanted to discuss, some of the hash rates and stuff like that. Now, for those that are new to mining too, the other thing I want to mention is you're probably wondering if you can mine Bitcoin with this, especially if you're brand new to mining. You probably read some article that you could mine Bitcoin with a GPU. And hypothetically, yes, you could download a Bitcoin mining client and mine Bitcoin with that card, but you're not going to want to because you would be competing against ASICs. So again, if you're new to mining, you're not going to want to mine Bitcoin with this card. You're going to want to try to mine some altcoins and stuff like that. And so when you get down into the hash rates and the power consumption, I've actually built a few rigs with this card, and it can mine somewhere around 20 to 22 mega hashes on Ethereum, and it gets a power consumption of around 90 watts. Now, these settings obviously are achieved through overclocking. And so if you're not familiar with overclocking, it's a way to kind of, tune the card so that it mines more efficiently. You can speed up the hash rates, you can lower the power consumption and get better overall efficiency out of it. And so to get that result, you would have to, do some optimization. The same thing with all these. And also too, I kind of want to mention, because I do get asked from time to time, what's the hash rate on a Monero? And so you don't want to mine Monero with this card. Typically, what you want to do is, again, you want to try and mine some other altcoins and stuff like that. And I'll get into that in a minute. But Monero has actually recently switched over to a CPU mineable algorithm called RandomX. And so it's no longer feasible and profitable to mine a Monero with a GPU. You actually get penalized for doing that. So I wouldn't recommend that. Another popular coin in the past, where I get asked about the hash rate is Zcash. And yes, the 1060, a lot of the NVIDIA cards, Zcash was a very, very popular coin to mine. And you could mine right around 300 to 320 sols while drawing about 100 watts from the wall, which is pretty good, right? But you're not going to want to mine Zcash with this coin either, or with this card either. Sorry about that. Because Zcash has actually been invaded by ASIC miners. So you don't, it's kind of like the same thing as mining Bitcoin. You don't want to mine Zcash with any GPU anymore, just because you're going to be competing against more advanced miners. And so it's going to make you less profitable. So some of the best coins to mine right now that I picked out based off of some of these calculators here, obviously, and I'll have links down to this as well from MinerStats. This is the mining calculator for the 1060 here. And one of the popular coins is going to be Grin. You can make right around about 46 cents a day right now if you were to mine Grin. The other popular coin that I've been mining with even the 1050 TIs is AION. And the thing I really like about AION is that you can mine it, and then you can put it in a staking wallet and kind of double mine it. So you can actually proof of stake that coin and you can proof of work that coin. So what that means is you could use your graphics card to mine, say, let's say you mined up 1,000 AION coins over the course of like 3 weeks, something like that. You could take those 1,000 coins, and instead of exchanging them for Bitcoin, you could lock them in a staking wallet on the AION blockchain and accumulate even more coins. So that's a pretty solid project. Again, not financial advice, but I've done some research about that project, and it is a very, very solid project. The other coins that I would recommend is Ethereum. Ethereum, according to What to Mine, and again, I'm going to have a link down in the description below to this. Ethereum is a very solid project to mine with the NVIDIA 1060 right now. Also, so is Ethereum Classic. So I do have those two listed as my top recommendations, given the current market situation. Obviously you're going to accumulate way more coins if you decide to mine Ethereum Classic, but that coin isn't worth as much. Again, Grin is a very solid coin to mine with this. I would definitely look into mining some Grin. There it is right there, Ethereum Classic. So kind of what I do with this to see what coins I should mine with these graphics cards is just kind of look at the calculator on What to Mine and look at the calculator on Miner Stats and just kind of compare them and see, you know, the similarities. So you can already see that we have Grin at the top here. You know, we have Grin somewhere at the top here as well. You know, you got Ethereum Classic. Again, we got Ethereum Classic here. You got, you know, this is recommended ETH hash, which is probably somewhere around, this is probably either Ethereum Classic or Ethereum for nice hash. So you just kind of want to look at these two and kind of compare them and just test it and see what works best for you. So the other coin that I would recommend that isn't necessarily on this list, maybe it might be on this list, but let me check, is Beam. Beam is another very solid project to mine with NVIDIA cards. So if you're looking to accumulate a spec coin, hang on to it long term and sell it as it goes up, I would definitely look into Beam. So, you know, as far as like the current profits go with the 1060, now this is, again, this is the 6 gig version. If you got the 3 gig version, you know, I'm not sure what you should mine with that card. I don't own any of those. I know that you can't mine Ethereum. There's a lot of, you know, with it only being 3 gigabytes, you can't mine a whole lot with the 3 gigabyte card. So, you know, I would recommend trying to trade that card in if you have a 3 gigabyte version and try to get you a 6 gigabyte card. But on the high end, you know, you're looking at probably somewhere around 18 cents a day is what you would make with a card like this. Now, keep in mind, the market is kind of suppressed. It's kind of low. So once the market bounces and returns, these profits would be much, much higher. You know, and kind of wrap this up, you know, so is the 1060 good for mining? Is it a good card to mine with? And I will say this, if you can pick it up on the secondhand market on eBay for right around 100 to 120 bucks, I might pick a few of these up. But here's the thing to keep in mind. There's way better cards out there, such as the 1660 Ti, the 1660 Super, also the 2060 Super, or, you know, you can even get some pretty good sick deals on a 580, 8 gig card. And so if you're looking to buy something brand new, I would not recommend buying the 1060 brand new, just because they are listed for like right around 400 bucks on Amazon. I can't find the link right now, but let me see here. Where was one at? Here's a 1060. They get it listed for, that's not too bad, 220, but some of these were listed at about $400, and I was just like, man, that's a real expensive price to pay, especially when you can get, you know, a 1660 Ti for right around 279 bucks, and you can actually get better performance. So, you know, my conclusion is this. Yes, it is a good card for mining still. I truly believe it's still going to be a good card to have, especially once the market returns. But again, I would not look at going out and buying it brand new. I would look at eBay and try to pick it up for like 100, 120 bucks. Most of these that I'm seeing here are going for like 165, 190, somewhere in that area. So, you know, keep that in mind. You know, if you already got one, then go ahead and mine with it. But if you don't have one, I would strongly suggest, again, look at the secondhand market. Don't buy it brand new. There's way better cards. So I have a link down in the description below to this blog article that we just published. Go ahead, check it out. And if you guys haven't already, I'll have a link down in the description below for this as well. Sign up for our private Facebook group. We answer a lot of great questions in there. We try to help people out that are new to mining. And even if you're not new to mining, go ahead, join us. We'd love to have you in there. And that's really it for now. So I hope you guys are all out there staying safe. I hope everybody's having a, you know, as good a time as you can on the quarantine. And that's really it. Be on the lookout for the next video. And, you know, get ready, because we're going to have some more content coming your way. So that's it. We'll see you next time.